Hi, I'm John. This is my show, An American Scheme, where I'm proving that Diana Ross is Michael Jackson's actual mother. So Macaulay Culkin has just done this interview for this Esquire magazine. And so, first of all, he gets right to the point, and it says, look, Culkin said, I'm going to begin with the line, it's not a line, it's the truth. He never did anything to me, speaking about Michael Jackson. I never saw him do anything, and especially at this flashpoint in time, I'd have no reason to hold anything back. The guy has passed on. If anything, I'm not going to say it would be stylish or anything like that. But right now is a good time to speak up. And if I had something to speak up about, I would totally do it. But no, I never saw anything. He never did anything. Okay, so he's talking about his relationship with Michael Jackson. And so he says one thing like, "Or it's not a lie, it's the truth, you know? He says he has no reason to hold anything back, and especially at this time. But then there's the thing about these people is they're always half-truths. They tell you the truth, but they never tell you the complete truth. And then there's also like coding and how they say things. You have to understand that they will tell you a piece of information, but they know that you don't actually understand all of it and stuff. So then they'll mislead you and stuff. And then so down here he talks about, he says, here's a good, okay, they were talking about Paris Jackson and stuff. So here it says, Culkin is godfather to Jackson's daughter Paris, to whom he remains close. He has shared with her his habit of stealing spoons from restaurants, bars, and cafes as a bit of harmless fun. The two give one another spoons as gifts, and they have matching spoon tattoos on their forearms. When Paris entered public life, Culkin had just one piece of advice. Given by virtue of the spoons. Don't forget to be silly. Don't forget to take something away from this whole experience. And don't forget to stick something up your sleeve. So, see how the spoon, he gives an explanation for what the spoon tattoo is, for why they've got those matching spoon tattoos. But things about like there, don't forget to keep something up your sleeve, right? And then, this is what I'm telling you about media and how they try to package things and stuff for them. I'm going to show you how it's misleading. It's truthful, but it's misleading, okay? See how we spoke about the silver spoon stuff, right? But now, in that thing right there, he doesn't, this is Macaulay Culkin on the Joe Rogan show, okay? So Macaulay Culkin didn't say anything about this when he was talking about the silver spoons. Now listen to this.
And one of my favorite theme songs, TV theme songs of all time.
Silver spoons.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so one of my favorite TV theme songs of all time. So he just because Joe was talking about the Schroeder kid that played the kid actor, and then they weren't talking about theme songs. They were talking about the kid, the Nick Schroeder, whatever his name is, Schroeder. And so they were talking about him, and then McCulkin just said, well, that's the Silver Spoon, because they were talking about that guy, and the kid starred on this TV show, Silver Spoons. So Culkin interjects, oh, well, Silver Spoons is one of my favorite TV theme songs of all time, okay? And then so I'm saying, not only is it a favorite TV theme song, now I'm going to play for you that song. This is the TV show, okay? Now look at here. This is the show Silver Spoons is about this kid who goes to live with his father that he had not lived with his whole life. I'm not sure if he knew him or exactly what this, but he had never lived with him. And I think his mother had passed away. Something like that had occurred. And then his father came back into his life, and his father ends up being super rich, okay? Now, it really resembles Silver Spoons. There's a lot of similarities to like the Neverland Ranch, you know? The guy lives like he's really rich. He lives like a kid. So when you'll see him in here and you'll see inside there's video games and stuff like that. That's because the dad had lived like that. It's like the dad's like a Michael Jackson kind of person. And then you'll see, listen to the song. It's, here we are face to face, a couple of silver spoons. We're hoping to find, we're two of a kind, you know? That's what the whole song's about. So when you take it in a relationship with Macaulay Culkin and Paris Jackson, the silver spoons, it's like he's giving you an explanation for what it is. And it's like, yeah, but he told you that Silver Spoons is one of his favorite TV theme songs. The TV show Silver Spoons really resembles Michael Jackson's life. And then there's the kid, the Alfonso, the kid that was in the Michael Jackson commercial, the tap dance kid, the kid that was played with Will Smith on that show too, Alfonso, whatever, he's in this thing too. So there's a thing with connection with Michael Jackson and Alfonso. There's a lot of stuff about this TV show, the Silver Spoon. So I'm going to play this the theme song for you here.
Here we are, face to face, a couple of silver spoons. Hoping to find we're two of a kind. Make it a go, make it grow. Together we're gonna find our way. Together taking the time each day to learn all about those things you just can't buy. Two silver spoons together.
Okay, you know, so two silver spoons together, you and I, you know? You know, so when you look at Macaulay Culkin and the tattoo he has with Paris Jackson and the silver spoons, and they put them together like a yin-yang, and he's saying, oh, it's an inside joke. Yeah, and he admits to saying it's always keep something up your sleeve. Okay, that's like a magic trick. That's a term from a magic trick. So then to put the silver spoon up his sleeve, he's admitting to you that those silver spoons have a symbolization to a magic trick. And what's the magic trip? It's you and I together, we're going to find our way, you know? That's them, the two silver spoons, trying to, always together, trying to make their way, like the theme song says, you know? That's what it is with him and Paris. And then so they tell you stuff in the interview, and they tell you truths, but then they don't. And I'm going to show you another one right now that happened today, because two of them happened today. So this one right here, they're doing a thing with Janet Jackson. And then they're saying, this is what they were saying, is anyone surprised that her child is going to be a prodigy, right? So it says here, let me see if a proud mama, yeah, so it says, Janet Jackson may be a world-renowned pop star, but the only musician she's interested in talking about is her three-year-old son, Eissa. She calls him Eissa, because that's like when Isis, his name's like, or is Isis. And then, but she calls him Eissa, because that's right when Isis became popular and they started coming out and said the Isis started taking us, so she started calling him Eissa. But so it's, proud Mama Jackson revealed that her young son already plays multiple instruments, like we're talking about a three-year-old kid, you know, and listens to classic music. It sounds like the Jacksons may dominate the next generation of music too. So, see what I'm saying with the Jacksons? They always do this with the Jacksons, but the one thing about the Jacksons, if you remove Michael Jackson's talent from the Jackson family, then you're going to be left with the Jacksons. And the thing that I'm going to show you, this is very commonly known in society that people don't understand what the Jacksons actually are, but a lot of people have seen this too, that the Jacksons, and you know, when we talk about cartoons, how they do this predicting, what's that actual term there? The predictable programming. Predictable programming. They're talking about predictable programming in cartoons and stuff, right? So this one right here, I want to show you because it's actually doing a predictable programming, but it just missed. But it caught on all the signs of the reality of what my reality is that Michael's not a Jackson, because that's the reality. Because Michael is not an actual Jackson, the signs showed through that he did not look like a Jackson, and there was no talent related to the Jackson compared to Michael, right? So those signs showed through, and because of that, you had this predictive programming through the cartoons, and this is a Black Dynamite cartoon about the Jacksons. Now listen to what they say, and like, see how the news people say, oh, Janet Jackson's got a kid, and now they're going to dominate the future. That's the way the news does, but the cartoons is the real people looking at shit the real way. And what they don't know is that Michael actually was not a Jackson, that they were right there. They were totally right on with what they're doing, but they just didn't understand exactly why they were right, because Michael's not a Jackson.
Black Dynamite, thank goodness you're here.
Michael Jackson ain't who he appears to be.
Your friend Cream Corn is in real trouble.
Told you.
Tell me more, Joe Jackson, and keep talking.
Well, it all started in a tiny little house in a small town called Gurry, Indiana. We was poor and life was ain't nothing to do in Gurry but all day and hope you make a talented baby. It seemed that every 9 months, Catherine would pop out another little Jackson. But each one was less talented than the last. Reba, Jackie, Tito, Jermaine, Shamo, Latoya, Marlon. Talk about a damn losing streak. Until one night.
What the heck?
I was amazed at first, but when I thought about it, whatever it was that got her pregnant just saved Joe Jackson 2 minutes of hard work. The very next day, my half-alien son, Michael Joseph Jackson, was born. I knew that baby wasn't mine, because that motherfucker had talent. Scary as it was the first time I saw it, the motherfucker sang and danced, and doing both really well. I needed a lead singer. That's when I decided to raise it as my own son, and the Jackson 5 was birthed. I sent Tito to the joke shop to find an afro wig and the widest toy nose he could find. And I had Catherine blacken him up the best she could. And the rest is music history.
Just get him an afro. That's it. Just get him an afro. He'll look like the rest of us. That's all they did with Michael in reality. Just give them all afros. Nobody will know the difference. That's like really what they did. And see, Janet came after Michael. So that's why they didn't mention her there and with the talent, because she's born after Michael. But the reality is after Michael was born, now they had an image of what to emulate, of what they were projecting as this is the Jackson image, and they had a talent for them to emulate, and that's how Janet Jackson was born, her whole entire life emulating Michael Jackson. So Janet Jackson, really, when you want to talk about her as what she is, really, she's just a Michael Jackson impersonator. That's it. She's not Michael Jackson. She has none of his real talent. They're not even blood related. None whatsoever. None of them. Just like this cartoon clearly says, I was on a loser streak. One loser after another. Well, the other one's worse after another. They're all like that. Janet would be just like that too. But she had the difference where her being younger, she's cute. She was cute when she was young too. So she was able to emulate Michael Jackson. That was the whole thing, because they knew now what we're going to do with her. But all the other kids that were older, they didn't get to live that because they didn't know Michael. They had to wait till Michael developed till they realized what they were going to do, you know? And so that's what I'm saying with this predictive programming in the cartoons. This is one that's going to come out in the future when my story breaks and it comes out that Michael's not an actual Jackson. The people are going to go back and look like on all the cartoons, like the Kobe Bryant helicopter crash and stuff. And this cartoon's going to come out and people are going to be like, oh my God, did you see this cartoon? It was straight out telling you. They knew Michael wasn't a Jackson. But what they really knew is that Michael does not look like a Jackson. That's why here it says, we got him an afro, we widened his nose up, put a little darker skin, because in actuality, he really doesn't look like the Jacksons. And then he says, Joseph, I knew that baby wasn't mine because this member had talent. That's the thing. Michael has talent. The Jacksons do not have talent. And people can see that. You don't have to have known the end. You don't have to know that Michael's. You don't have to know the real story. Okay. But in the process of looking at them, people see the same thing. Michael has extraordinary talent that has nothing to do with what the Jacksons are. And when they're talking about the Jacksons as a family and that there's family talent, and oh, and Janet Jackson's going to have a kid and it's going to keep the continuation of the Jackson talent going on, it's like, that's just garbage. That's this junk that they keep feeding you. That's just trash. Because in reality, like the cartoon knows, this kid's got talent. None of my other kids got talent. None of them have talent. And you know what? Michael doesn't even look like these kids. So because then they start calling him an alien baby because something's wrong here. But they didn't actually know, because of the fact that Michael was raised in the Jackson household, that image was so strong to everybody. Nobody was able to overcome that. But I finally overcame it. and realized that Michael's not actually a Jackson, that he was given to the Jacksons from his real parents, Diana Ross and Smokey Robinson, and that's where all Michael's alien God-gifted talent comes from. That's why Joseph knew how to nurture that talent, because as soon as Michael showed signs of the talent, then Joseph knew where he got this kid from, and he knew that this kid has real talent. He knew instantly, I knew that's not one of my kids, this kid's got real talent. He knew as soon as the kid showed talent, oh, this kid's got talent. So, my kids, you be little dancers. You guys do your little dancing, do be some little doo-wop singers and shit, but you're not the talent. Michael's the freaking talent. It was always that way. You know? Just put a wig on him, you know? And that's the rest of the rest is history.